Canadians understand that Canada is not immune from the threat of global terrorism. Last October, we saw two terrorist attacks on our own soil, and the lives of two brave Canadian troops that were taken by terrorists inspired by the genocidal organization, the so-called Islamic State in Iraq and the Levant. This is an organization that is trying to create a terror state that through genocide is seeking to wipe off the face of the earth the ancient indigenous vulnerable minority communities of the ancient areas of Mesopotamia in the Middle East. An organization that has declared war and hostility on Canada and which has called on its followers to kill Canadians wherever they can find us. Over 130 Canadians have traveled abroad to join this genocidal organization that we are aware of. Just this week, one of them was charged by the Royal Canadian Mounted Police based on new criminal powers that we added through legislation in this past session of Parliament. Our government has deployed the brave women and men of the Canadian Armed Forces to tackle this growing threat of international terrorism as part of an international coalition created at the invitation of the government of Iraq through the United Nations. We have deployed some six CF-18 fighter jets that have struck dozens, actually run more than 200 sorties against ISIL targets, as well as two modernized Aurora reconnaissance aircraft, which have played a critical role in targeting and situational awareness for the International Military Coalition, and a Polaris air refueler, together with the presence on the ground in the Kurdish region of northern Iraq of some 69 Special Operations Forces from the Canadian Special Operations Command, made up jointly of members of CSOR, the Canadian Special Operations Regiment, based out of Petawawa, Ontario, and Joint Task Force 2 from Dwyer Hill, Ontario, Canada's most elite Special Operations Forces unit. We depend on our Special Operations Forces as the pointiest edge of the spear in the defense of Canada and our interests and values around the world. These men and women did brilliant work for Canada during their deployment in Afghanistan, and they're doing brilliant work today in training the Kurdish Peshmerga, who constitute part of the Iraqi security forces, to help to defend the innocent civilians and the millions of internally displaced victims of ISIL in northern Iraq.